In this video, I'm going to show you how to fund your Zk Sync wallet or how to send ETH to your Zk Sync wallet using a centralized exchange or using a bridge. So let's get started. Hello everyone, welcome to One Life Investments, where I create helpful and beginner-friendly crypto content and guides. If this video was helpful, please leave a like and subscribe and hit the bell icon so that you don't miss out on our future uploads as well. Before jumping in the video, I just want to remind you that there are other airdrops or potential airdrops that might be happening soon in the future. And if you haven't checked them out, make sure that you check them out in our channel. I'll leave a link to the playlist as well in the description or in the top right corner so they can check that out as well. Moving on with the tutorial, there's two main ways you can fund your Zk Sync wallet. First, what you need to understand is Zk Sync is currently live on two different environments. First is your Zk Sync version 1 on mainnet, meaning there's different applications that are running on Zk Sync at the moment. And there is something called Zk Sync version 2 testnet that is running on Rinkaby testnet. Now, if you are trying to use the testnet, make sure that you watch that tutorial. And if you are trying to use Zk Sync version 1 and you're trying to fund your wallet to use the dApps that have been deployed on Zk Sync version 1, for example, Zigzag Exchange, and you can follow this guide. If you are still confused, please reach out to me on Twitter at One Life Investment, or just leave a comment and I'll make sure that I reply to your question. Now, first, as always, I'm going to use MetaMask. If you are not using MetaMask, or if you are not aware how to use MetaMask or set up MetaMask, please watch that video first. And once you have MetaMask set up, or if you have any other wallet that is self-custody wallet, then you use that wallet as well. Now, I'm going to show you how to use a bridge, but I'm not going to commit my transaction, but you can definitely follow along. But I'm definitely going to go through the whole process of sending ETH from FTX to your Zk Sync, and you can follow that to use a centralized exchange, for example, Coinbase, Binance, or KuCoin, or any other centralized exchanges to fund your Zk Sync version 1 wallet. So if you go to Zk Sync ecosystem, you can have a look at different applications that are currently live or will be live in the future. As you can see, Zigzag Exchange or the Orbiter Finance is live. So you can use Orbiter Finance. I haven't used it, so I cannot recommend or suggest, but you can try out and see if that's any good. But for the purpose of this video, I'm going to show you how to use Zigzag Exchange. Now, there are rumors that Zigzag will do an airdrop for itself. So it's a exchange or decentralized exchange that is running on Zk Sync version 1 mainnet. You can actually use this to actually trade different assets, for example, USDC, USDT, AVAX, Luna, and a bunch of different other assets that weren't available at the time of me making the old video, but you can do that. But the other option that we have now is called a bridge. So if you click on bridge and then you connect your wallet, and what you do is ETH, as you can see on the top, you are sending from ETH L1, layer 1, to Zk Sync layer 2. You select ETH. Why I suggest you send ETH is because there's no faucet at the moment that you can request some ETH from. Or even though there is one, it'd be easier for you to, instead of waiting for some ETH to pay for your gas fees, you can just straight away send ETH, and then you can just carry out your transactions yourself without having to rely on a faucet or someone else to give you some ETH for transaction fees. So always just bridge ETH. So send ETH straight away. It makes your life very easy. So we'll select ETH. But if you want to send other assets, go for it. But you might run into different issues in terms of being able to pay for the gas fees while using the dApps, right? So select your ETH, select the amount, and then just transfer. Click on transfer, click on approve my MetaMask, and that's how you can just bridge your assets from layer 1 to layer 2. But how do you send ETH from a centralized exchange, for example, Binance, FTX, KuCoin, almost any exchange, to Zk Sync? There's a service called Layer Swap, which allows you to do this and not pay ridiculous amount of fees. So at the moment, if you are using a bridge or a normal way to bridge your assets from ETH layer 1 to Zk Sync layer 2, you might have to pay hundreds of dollars in transaction fee while just sending your assets. But with Layer Swap, you just pay a fixed fee depending on the amount of assets you are transferring, and then you get your assets very quickly as compared to your other decentralized way, for example, a bridge or a ramp, right? So what you do is you go to layerswap.io. There are rumors that there might be an airdrop in the future, but I don't know if Layerswap needs a token. But if there is one, then it's actually even better, right? So go to layerswap.io. You can choose from which exchange you're going to use. You can decide which one you have your assets on. I'm going to use ftx.com to zk-sync. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy my address and paste. I'm going to send. If I go to my FTX wallet, as you can see, I have 0.0369 ETH. I'm going to send 0.03 ETH to zk-sync, right? As you can see, so I've entered my amount. I've selected the asset, which is ETH, and I've selected my exchange, which is FTX, and copied and pasted my MetaMask address to network zk-sync. As you can see, you can use it for different other networks as well. Once you've entered everything, click on swap now. It's just asking you to confirm that the information that you've provided is correct. That's fine, providing, confirm. What you need to do now is you need to create a account, right? As you're going to create an account with your Brandsfer. Why do we need to create this account? Is because the way Layerswap actually works. So I'm going to explain that in a second, but first let's just create an account. Click on register, and this is just a quick, you can also use a Twitter to log in. I'm going to just use my Twitter, authorize the app. All right, so now it says, please provide read-only API keys. Now, this is where you need to learn a bit about your exchange. For example, if you have FTX, you can just follow what I'm doing now. If you have Binance, just do a Google search on how to create API keys for your exchange. API keys for Binance, API keys for KuCoin and stuff like that. So what are API keys? API keys are basically a set of keys that you create for your account. And if you give that key to a third party application or a third party person, they can access your account and use that key to access your account and use your account. Now, depending on the level of access you provide on that API key, it determines what level of access and what level of authentication that the third party has. So you need to create an API key which allows to transfer asset from your FTX account to Layerswap's FTX account, and once they receive that fund, they send fund to your zk-sync wallet. So there's a reason why you are not paying ridiculous amount of fees, because you are getting fund directly from a centralized exchange or a centralized account, and that account is managed by Layerswap. So you basically, so you go to FTX, go to your account, go to API, and what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna create a read-only API key and copy and paste the API key and the API secret. Make sure that you give it a read-only API access. So depending on what kind of exchange you're using, there might be different options as to what kind of authentication you can provide. So after entering everything, click on connect. I'm not gonna save that. I'm gonna go confirm swap. As you can see, payment method is ftx.com, amount 0.03. Transfer is saying is 0 ETH. So it's probably not zero, but 0 point something. Now it's saying go to FTX and do a withdrawal to the provided address, right? So copy that, go to withdrawals, you go ETH, amount 0.03, that, right? Withdrawal method, ETH. And once you've entered your amount, once you've entered the ETH address, this is the address provided by Brandsfer. So make sure that the address is correct. And what it's doing now, it's waiting for you to send 0.03 ETH to that address. And once that address receives 0.03 ETH, then it will release that fund to your zk-sync wallet. So I'm going to go and withdraw. And if you come here and wait, it will increase, the received amount will increase. And once the address detects that you have actually sent 0.03, the full amount that you wanted to withdraw to zk-sync, then as you can see, the processing has started, swap successful, your swap successfully completed. You can view it in Explorer or go ahead, swap more. That's fine. So if you want to look in the transaction, you can click swap, you can click view in Explorer. This will open the zk scan. So this is similar to your Ether scan. And as you can see, it's initiated, created less than a minute ago, and it will probably take a few minutes for zk-sync to actually send me the assets. All right, so that's how you can use a centralized exchange to fund your zk-sync wallet and also use a bridge to send assets to your zk-sync wallet. If you have any questions, please reach out to me in the comments down below. But if you think this video was useful, please leave a like and subscribe and hit the bell icon for more tutorials like this in the future. Thank you, and you have a nice day.